Testex now offers a digital version of its micrometric thickness gauge. Earlier, analog thickness gauges were provided in two models. On the left, the inch version with numbered divisions indicating mils or thousandths of an inch, and on the right, the metric version with numbered divisions indicating micrometers. The newer device measures in both sets of units and is capable of uploading measurements to a computer. Obtaining a measurement starts with turning the gauge on by pressing and holding the on-off button, then presetting to subtract the thickness of the replica film's incompressible layer. Presetting is done by pressing the origin button. The mil micrometer button allows the user to switch between inch units, here mils, and metric units, here micrometers. The set and toggle buttons are not used. Recording a measurement requires pressing the button on the back of the gauge. A tactile click and faint beep will tell you the measurement has been saved. Now that we've saved a null measurement, we will also record several actual tape thickness measurements. Uploading measurements first requires plugging a USB cable into the gauge and into your computer. Now, open a spreadsheet like Microsoft Excel or OpenOffice Calc and click one of the cells. Start the upload by firmly pressing the same button you used for recording. Your most recent measurements will populate the spreadsheet. Different columns will indicate from left to right the gauge serial number, the measurement sequence number, the date, the time, the replica film thickness measurement, and the measurement units in mils or micrometers. A quick but firm press of the button gives you those measurements made since your last upload. A longer 5-second press of the button will give you all measurements stored in the gauge. This can be as many as several hundred. Remember, the button at back functions in two different ways depending on whether or not the gauge's USB cable is plugged in. If the cable is unplugged, the button records measurements. If the USB cable is plugged in, the button uploads measurements. It's also important to keep in mind the two kinds of battery that gauge operation requires. One is a replaceable type 357 silver oxide battery that powers the encoder. You can access it by pulling up on the cover at top front. The second battery is rechargeable and powers the data recording and upload module in back. This second battery recharges whenever the USB cable is plugged in. Full recharge can require the unit's USB cable to remain plugged in overnight. Full details on this and other Testex products can be found at www.testextape.com.